So let's have quiet, guys, quiet. So the first principle is, when you have possession, make the field as big as possible. Let's look at some examples of that. This is Real Madrid against Manchester City. Watch this now. So City has the ball, midfielder has the ball. Look at the winger over here. He's all the way on the right side by the line. Look at the winger over here, all the way on the left side of the line. Center forward is in central and high. Attacking midfielder doesn't come to the ball, stays away from the ball. So you can see now, because of the team shape of Manchester City, they have so many options. They can play through balls to the center forward, they can play the ball to the wingers, they can switch it all the way to this space over here for the other winger to run into. This attacking midfielder can make a run maybe and get a ball here. Plenty of options over here. Why? Because they make the field big. Let's look at another example. Let's now look at, this is the region 2000 team on their trip to Argentina from 2016, like about 3 years ago. They are the white team, they're playing against the club Racing or Racing club from Argentina in Buenos Aires. See how the white team, our Asian team, makes the field as big as possible. See, the winger is all the way on that side, the left winger. The right winger is all the way here behind the tree. There he is. So by staying wide, the two wingers staying wide, it really stretched the other team's back line. We could find them gaps to play through balls for our wingers to run off. So that's how you make the field as big as possible. The next principle is peeling off. Every player ahead of the ball needs to peel off and find a way to receive the ball facing upfield. Same game again. Watch this guy here, attacking midfielder over here. He's peeling off now, opening up his body so he can receive the ball facing upfield. Look at the way he receives the ball. He's facing the right way and he feeds the winger. So in two passes, we managed to penetrate all the way into the penalty area. Watch this player, the Bruin. Watch how he peels off also. He's looking around him to see what's going on. Now he's peeling off, opening up his body, and voila. Switches it to the other side. Very, very simple. If the positioning is good, then it makes the game so much easier. Here is our ODP team. In an interregional event, we are the dark team. Watch the number 6 over here, how he opens up his body facing the field. See how he's peeling off now? Opens up his body, gets the ball facing the right way. He's able to switch it to the other side. So that's peeling off. The third principle is bending runs. Let's see some examples of that. So watch Ronaldo. There is Ronaldo. Watch what he does. He's bending his run right now. Now he's facing the right way and he almost scores. Bending run. Look what it created. A goal chance. Some more examples. Watch this play over here. Watch this play over here. See what he does. I think this is Atletico Madrid. Bent his run. So he's not offside. Oh. To create a chance, he should have bent the ball too. He should have bent his shot. Let's go. put the ball on the far post. Watch this play over here. This is, I think this is Turkey against England. Watch this play over here. Right now he's very narrow, he's too much inside. Watch him how he bends his run, pulls the defender towards him, creates a passing lane for a through ball. Let's see what he does now. This time it's goal. Finally, you got a goal. Watch this now. We are defending right now. We are the top team. Okay, you know who the player is now that just won the ball? His name is Chris Richards. You know where he plays right now? Bayern Munich. Via Dallas FC. Via the ODP. Anyway, he won the ball. He's getting out of the back line. Watch out number 9, bending run. Watch. There it is. Creates a passing lane for a through ball. And he gets himself a breakaway. He missed the goal. That's why I stopped it here. Got to open finishing. Runs, trigger runs. This is the center forward. I think it's Ronaldo. He's checking to the ball. So the attacking midfielder is going to take his place. Let's watch. There he is. There he is. Coming. Attacking midfielder took his place. So they switched, they interchanged. That was a nice defensive clearance. Another example here, right team has to go around the Welsh attacking midfielder makes a run. He's behind the back line. There he is. Checks to the ball now, gets the ball, plays the winger, attacking midfielder takes his place and goes in to meet the cross and scores on the rebound. So the 10 got the ball with a nice diagonal pass. The 9 checks to the ball, gets the ball, first time pass to the winger, again diagonal pass. The 8 comes from nowhere, sprints ahead of the 9. Missed the cross and scores. So about 5 or 6 principles of possession soccer have been applied in this particular sequence. And that's what created the goal. Diagonal passes are much more effective than vertical passes. See over here. There is one, there is another one. Now look at the long one, diagonal ball to the other side. Now look at another one now to Aguero, to speed off, facing the right way. So you see, it's a sequence of diagonal balls which achieve penetration all the way to the center forward. Another one, diagonal ball, the player facing the right way. Another example, there is one, 1, 2, 3. Thank you. diagonal balls in the changing positions. There is a good one. Switch the point of attack all the way to the right winger. Back again in the middle. To the center forward, diagonal ball. Good turn, good shot, blocked. Watch this sequence. That's vertical pass, we don't want to do too many of those. There is one, there is a diagonal ball. There's another one to the winger. Watch this, they're pressing us. The Argentina team is pressing us. Look at the six. The six waits patiently over here. Now he's going to get the ball. We're going to break pressure from the nine ball to the six. Look at the eight where he is waiting patiently all on the other side. He gets the ball, the diagonal ball. Now the winger. So very neat and tidy. With the right positioning and diagonal balls, we break the pressure from the other team, get out and penetrate deep into their territory. Diagonal balls, that's the way to go. Every back pass followed by a switch. There is a back pass, that's going to be followed by a switch. This is the throwing, play back. And switch quickly, all the way to the other side. Nice and tidy. Right now we're defending. We've got the white team. Just win the ball, play back pass, followed by a switch. Now it comes to our right side. Now it goes back to the center. The other side again. All the way to the left side. Now our center forward is going to come and get the ball. We're going to play a back pass. Followed by a switch. Just made it. This game 3-1. This team went to Argentina and they played four games in Argentina in 2016. They won two games 3-1, they tied one game 1-1, and they lost one game 2-1. They did really, really well. And the Argentinian coaches told us that the Argentinian players are better individually, but our team was better tactically. That's the biggest compliment you can get from an Argentinian coach. So again, that's because these players are intelligent. They learn how to apply the principles and they did it consistently. And you can do it also. Next one. Ball doesn't stay too long in the same area. One or two passes goes, does it? Goes to the other side. Now you're coming to the right side. Now to the center again. Now to the left side again. We want the ball on the right side. By the way, the two passes, we get all the way to the left side. It's like I told you earlier. You win the ball on the right, go to the left, and then attack. Let's see how long the ball stays on this side. Look at the switch. Look how wide the winger is. So was this attack successful? Because the ball never stayed in the same place too long. They kept moving the ball all over the field, from the right, from the left to the right, back to the left again, and then a chance to go. Principle number 8, keeper doesn't punt. Every time he gets the ball, he rolls it out quickly. Gets the ball, and by the way, rolls it out to the defender. Watch this now, they're pressing us, the keeper has the ball over here. So he doesn't go to the 4 or the 5, instead he finds the 6. And we get out. And then the last principle, that's number 9. Use the throwing to switch the point of attack. So look at this now. Real Madrid has the throwing. Manchester City is pressing them. Which player is free right now? This one here, the 5. The 5, let's see what happens. That's what happens. Very smart throwing.
So good luck to you, and looking forward to seeing you play. Thank you very much.